One of these men is Jack Benny's violin teacher. What is your name, please?
My name is Larry Kirkchi.
My name is Larry Kirkchi.
My name is Larry Kirkchi.
Only one of these people is the real Larry Kirkchi. The other two are imposters and will try to fool this panel. Johnny Carson, Kitty Carlisle, Don Ameche, and Polly Bergen on To Tell the Truth with your host, Bud Collier.
Thank you very much. Good evening and welcome once again to Tell the Truth. Brought to you this week by Helene Curtis, makers of fine beauty products, creators of Enden Dandruff Treatment Shampoo and Tender Touch Dry Skin Bath Oil. All right, panel, will you please, for the first time, open your envelopes and remove your affidavit cards and follow along as I read. I, Larry Kirkchi, am a violinist. I played for 2 years with the Boston Symphony, for 2 years with the Cleveland Symphony, and for 23 years have played with the orchestra on the Jack Benny Show. I am now the first violinist on the show, and for the past 5 years, I have been Jack Benny's violin teacher. Signed, Larry Kirkchi. Three gentlemen to start things off tonight, panel, each one claiming to be, as you heard, Larry Kirkchi, Jack Benny's violin teacher. And let's begin this first round of questioning with Kitty Carlisle.
Thank you, Bud. Number one, where did you teach Jack Benny?
At his home, in his bathroom.
In Hollywood. Number two, where does he, what street does he live on?
Roxbury Drive.
Number three, what is his daughter's name?
Joni.
Number one, who is Leopold Auer?
Leopold Auer is a violin teacher.
Number two, who was the conductor of the Boston Symphony when you played with it?
Monteux.
Number three, who was the conductor of the Boston Symphony when you played with it?
Pierre Monteux.
And you, number one?
Karl Muck.
Number two, Karl Muck. Number two, could you tell me, do you know somebody called Harry Dixon?
I didn't hear you.
Do you know somebody called Harry Dixon?
No.
Number three, can you tell me the number of Mr. Benny's... well, no, I shouldn't ask you, I suppose. Tell me, do you know Joni's governess's name?
I never knew Joni's governess.
You never knew Joni's governess.
Don Ameche, please.
Number two, where is Jack Benny from?
Waukegan.
Jack Benny's sponsors been for the last 5 years?
Lipton Tea, Nationwide... Lucky Strike.
Number three, who is his present announcer?
Don Wilson.
Number two, would you say that's right?
Yes.
Number two, what is the address of Jack Benny's home on Roxbury Drive? Number two?
10-10-2, should I give it?
Number
right?
Three, do you know?
Next door to Lucille Ball.
Number one. That's being cagey. Later we'll ask him where Lucille Ball is. Polly.
Number one, what song did I sing on the Jack Benny Show? Number two, do you remember?
I don't.
Number three?
I am so busy trying to play.
I see. Number two.
He must have been very good, Tom.
I must have been very good, right, yes. Number two, who is the orchestra leader on the Jack Benny Show?
Malin Merrick.
And number one, who's the orchestra leader on the Jack Benny Show?
Malin Merrick.
Number three?
Malin Merrick.
Is he the orchestra leader every week, number three?
Yes, though he wasn't the orchestra leader the night you sang.
Who was, number three?
Mr. Abbey.
Number two, do you agree with that?
I don't remember.
Number one, do you remember?
No, I think it was Lynn Murray.
None of these three gentlemen are Larry Kirkchi. Or else they've confused me with Patty Page.
Johnny Kirk.
Which is possible.
But
except
not probably.
She has hit records and I don't.
And she's blonder than you. Johnny.
Number one, what is Jack Benny's real name?
I don't know.
You don't know. Number two, what is Jack Benny's real name?
I don't remember it.
Number three, what is Jack Benny's real name?
Jack Benny.
His real name. Not Jack. His stage name. How old is Jack? Number one, how old is Jack Benny really?
Oh, 39.
Now cut that out. Heavens to Betsy, you know he's not 39. Number three, what is the drummer's name on the Jack Benny, in the Jack Benny Orchestra? Number three, what is the drummer's name?
Lester Guitar.
Lester Guitar.
And the guitar player is Saul Drummer.
Well, Saul Drummer. Sam Drummer, I think it's his brother. Well, that's all the time we have, panel.
One more question.
No, I'm sorry, you can't.
Why does he practice in the bathroom?
I'll ask that later. I'm
okay.
Interested in that myself. All right. Time to vote, so without consultation, will you mark your ballots for number one, number two, or number three? The team of challengers will, as usual, receive $250 for every incorrect vote. All set, panel? Everyone voted? Okay, Johnny, for whom did you vote this first round?
Well,
I voted for number three, because he looks like he has enough courage to teach Jack the violin. When's he going to learn to play it? I voted for three. Kitty, your vote, please.
Well, I voted for number one. I don't think that Pierre Monteux has ever been the permanent conductor of the Boston Symphony, and to dig up a name like Carl Mook, you must know about orchestras.
Don, what about your selection?
Boy, I was under the impression that Jack's home was like 1019 instead of 1002, and I think his violin teacher should know that, and I was under the impression Lucille Ball lived in the Valley. Maybe I'm, that might be,
so
I
number,
number
one.
One.
Is your vote, is
I'm sorry,
excuse number
me.
Number one, okay. And Polly, which one do you think is the real one? Well, just for the sake of the show, pick one.
If they can't remember the name of my song, I can't remember which one is Larry Wesson's.
What did you think?
I sang Body and Soul, and David Rose was the orchestra leader the week I was on. And I voted for number three, and if it is him...
You hate
yourself. I'm furious at you, sir.
But I will tell you...
Now, it's too late to make up.
Hold the emotions until we find out how right or wrong we are. Then we can do what we like. But let's see which one of these gentlemen is the real violin teacher to Jack Benny. So will the real Larry Kirchy please stand up. Okay.
I told you it wasn't any of them.
All right. Thank you very much, sir. Well, let's find out about the others now. Number one, tell us your real name and what you really do.
My name is Jules Nasberg. I'm an insurance broker in New York City.
Thank you, sir. And number three, your real name and what you really do.
I'm Lester Cohen. My last book sold 1 million copies, and I'm going to make a movie out of it.
What's the name of it?
Coming Home, but the name of the movie will be My Body.
Well, good luck. Good luck to you. Well, in checking over the score, we find that there were, let me see, 1, 2, 3, 4 incorrect votes, so the total of $250 each of a grand total of $1,000 from Aline Curtis, and a gift package of fine products from Aline Curtis for the ladies of each of you. And quickly, does he learn in the bathroom to fiddle?
He started studying in the bathroom.
Sounds better that way?
Well, Mary thought it was more.
Mary
obvious.
Thought it was the best place for him. Well, gentlemen, thank you very much for being with us. Good night and good luck to you. All right, panel, let's meet our next team of challengers.
What is your name, please?
My name is Lucy Chamblett.
My name is Lucy Chamblett.
My name is Lucy Chamblett.
Again, follow along, if you will, panel, with your affidavit cards. I, Lucy Chamblett, am records clerk and pistol instructor for the police department of Winter Haven, Florida. I have won some 200 medals and 30 trophies for my marksmanship, and am the first woman in history to ever win a place on the formerly all-male U.S. International Pistol Team.
This year I am, for the second time, the National Women's Pistol Champion. Signed, Lucy Chambliss. Now we welcome three alert young ladies, each claiming to be Lucy Chambliss, National Pistol Champion. Now let's begin this round of questioning with Johnny Carson.
Well, Bud, I should disqualify myself right off. I was shot by one of these women last week in Florida myself. number one, how do they score a police pistol meet?
By 10 being the bullseye, 9, 8, 7, 6. High score.
Number two, how do they score a police pistol meet?
10 is the shot of highest value, and it ranges out to 5, to the 5 ring.
Number three, do you have a moonlighting job in Winter Haven, Florida? What is the standard, number two, what is the standard police pistol bore?
38 caliber.
Number one, what is the standard police pistol?
38 caliber.
Kitty?
Number one, what is your job as records clerk? What do you do?
I handle the arrest. I make keep files on that. Also insurance policies. Any new people that come into town, they're all registered.
Number two, is this under the civil service?
No, it is not.
Number three, is this under the civil service?
No.
What is it? Where is this place in Florida, Winter Haven?
It's about in the middle of the state.
Are you? Do you go sunbathing?
On the weekend, sometimes.
Do you come from... are you born in Florida?
No, I was born in South Carolina.
Don?
Number three, how many size pistols are there?
Well, I use three different ones. I use the 22, 38, and the 45.
Number one, what finger do you use to pull the trigger?
The third.
Show me which one, would you please? Use that finger?
Mm-hmm.
Number two, would you show me how you pull the trigger?
Straight back.
No other way to go.
You use the index finger, is that correct?
That's correct.
Number three, do you use the index finger also? How do you pull the trigger?
I just squeeze back.
Number one, what does a bore mean?
A bore is the end of the bullet.
Number two, does a bullet go... Polly?
Number two, how much money do you have to steal to make it, to change it from a misdemeanor to a felony? I have a perfect right.
What are you planning?
I want to, yeah.
I believe it's over $25.
Number three, do you agree with that?
I think it's up to $50.
Number two, what's the difference between a misdemeanor and a felony?
Oh, well,
besides $25.
The punishment, for one thing, it is much greater. You can receive up to life, I suppose, for a felony.
I see. Number three, who was the champion?
Pray
the woman's pistol champion.
I can pray that's it. Time to shoot your ballot. Instead of bullets, will you please mark them up now and select which one you think is the real one. So without consultation, select by your voting number one, number two, or number three. Okay, Johnny, which is your choice this time?
Well, I chose number one because I'm only judging when they stood up there. Before they came down, she looked like the perfect 38.
Ooh. And certainly no bore, right? Kitty.
Oh, didn't I write it down? My God. Oh, I had it down. Well,
you
what
sure?
Do?
I don't know.
Oh, yes,
there it is.
Here it is. Here it is. Yeah. I voted for number three. I think the bore of a gun is the
that's right, Kitty.
The,
that's
you know.
Right. At least now, we know that you know.
What
was that again?
It's the inside of the thing where the trajectory of the bullet goes. I've never shot a bullet in my life in a gun, but I'm trying to squeeze. I don't think you squeeze it with the third finger. I would squeeze it with the second finger. Number two has very, very long fingernails, and I don't believe she's a pistol champion. I think it's number three.
Maybe she pulls the trigger with her fingernails. You can't tell. Don, your vote, please.
I voted for number three because number one didn't know what bore meant, and I've always been in the front. You can use the third finger. Some people do, but also it's a requisite that you must squeeze the trigger and not jerk the thing.
Holly?
I voted for number three. First of all, she was the quietest
And as I said before, my nurse says it's the quietest. Number two was almost as quiet, but not quite. And number one was a little bit too loud when she said it was that finger. Because I would think that would be very crippling.
Especially to the guy you were aiming at.
Right.
All right, let's get... But our minds made up. Let's find out which one of these three young ladies is the real national pistol champion for the ladies. So, will the real Lucy Chambliss please stand up? Congratulations. It's a pleasure to have you on the show.
Oh, no. All together. Everybody up. Everybody up. Out.
Be careful. They're armed.
Twice in a row that we miss everyone.
Twice
That's
in a row.
Not a bad
you
average.
Fooled the battle 100%. Let's find out about the others. Number one, what is your real name and what do you do?
My name is Alex Lee Boatwright, and I'm in the publicity department of Universal International Pictures.
Thank you, ma'am. Number three, your real name and what you really do.
My name is Marge Howell, and I'm on the production staff of the Jack Parr Show.
Well, panel, you did real well. And the number of times I hear Jack talk about how little money he has on the show, you may have done better tonight than working for him. I don't know. $1,000 for having all incorrect at $250 each. And that, of course, is from Aline Curtis, as well as a gift package of their fine products. Thank you so much for having fun with us. We enjoyed having you. Good night and good luck. Now, panel, let's meet our third team of challengers.
What is your name, please?
My name is Rob Sagendorf.
My name is Rob Sagendorf.
My name is Rob Sagendorf.
Again, please read along with me as I read aloud to you. I, Rob Sagendorf, am the publisher of the old Farmer's Almanac, which has appeared in a new edition every year since 1793. This year, we will distribute over 1 million copies. The 1961 book adheres to the traditional format and contains astronomical data, crop planting tables, and postal rate information. It also contains a compilation of the best days for fishing, as well as useful information on auto laws, game laws, marriage laws, and bird migration. This year, the book has a few special features, such as a recipe for cooking eggs in maple syrup, and an article on the 15 different kinds of kisses. The Almanac's most important feature, however, is our advanced forecast of the weather for the entire year of 1961. Signed, Rob Sagendorf. Now three claimants to the name and title of Rob Sagendorf, publisher of the Farmer's Almanac, and we begin this round of questioning with Don Amici. Don?
Number three, where do you get your information for forecasting the weather?
Well, we consult the United States Weather Bureau, and then we use our own weather forecaster, Lauren Arnold.
Mm-hmm. Number two, what is agronomy?
Something to do with hens.
Number one, would you agree with that?
I think it has to do with farming in general, but I wouldn't swear to it.
Number three, why do you rotate crops?
Well, generally, because if you use the same crop in the same area of land, you tend to wear it out. And if you mix your crops up over years, you tend to get better production.
Number one, what causes soil erosion?
The rain washing down and taking the earth away.
Thank you. Number two, what does hybrid mean?
I beg your pardon.
I'm afraid we can't wait for it. Polly?
Number two, what's the weather like? What's the weather going to be like in Las Vegas in July? I have to be there, and I'd like to know what kind of clothes to take.
Well, you should take your skis and snow trousers. And
I see. Thank you.
You ask a silly question, you get a silly answer.
I don't know what's silly about wanting to know what the weather's like. The Almanac is famous for telling you what... I think it's a little daring to advance, give the forecast for the year when they usually miss from day to day. But number one, no, as a matter of fact, I've understood. Number one, hasn't the Almanac had the best advanced weather forecast of almost any publication that's ever been put out on weather?
We think so. We
Number
like
two,
think so.
What is ichthyoc serious?
I'm afraid you're going to get a how's that again, so I better go to Johnny Garson.
That
Johnny?
That doesn't seem quite fair.
Number two, spell your last name.
S-A-G-E-N-D-O-R-P-H.
Number three, how do you spell it?
I agree.
You can't fight that. Number one, which is the only... You have something here on new marital laws, marriage laws. What is the only state in the United States in which you can legally be married at 14 years of age?
There are two, I believe. North Carolina and New York, that is with parents' consent.
Now he tells me.
Did he?
Number three, who started the Farmer's Almanac in 1793?
Well, actually, it was produced in 1792 for publication in 1793 by Robert B. Thomas.
Number one, can you tell me these 15 different kind of kisses? Are those physical kisses or candy kisses?
Physical kisses.
Number one, give me three kinds of kisses. Yeah. I don't mean give them to me. I mean tell me.
Kidding.
That's good. Delighted.
Have him give you the three you don't know about. Did you hear what he answered,
no,
Bud?
No.
Bud says, Brian, he says, I'd be delighted. Well, I guess I'm not going to find out. But I'll tell you what, you're going to have a late date with him backstage, and he'll deliver it in person to you. Time is ripe now to vote. If you will, please mark your ballots and do so without consultation. Vote for number one, number two, or number three. Everybody set?
No.
No?
I know who it is. I'm going to vote for the wrong person.
Vote for the one that you know it is.
No? Because I don't think it's him.
All right, Johnny, for whom did you vote this trip?
Well, we've all had such a good run of luck tonight. What's the use anymore? But I'm from the Midwest, and I'm just taking the gentleman who looks more like a Midwesterner, number one.
Okay, Kitty?
I voted for number three. I thought it was number one. Number two said that agrarianism had to do with hens, and I think it's farming.
Agronomy.
Well, agrarianism. And number three had corrected me on and corrected the affidavit on the time that the first edition came out. So I voted for number three.
Don Amici.
Well, it's probably number three, but I voted for number one despite the fact you didn't know exactly what agronomy was.
And Polly?
Well, I thought it was number one. I voted for number three. I think erosion is a little more than the water just washing away the earth. It's a little more complicated than that. Also, the agronomy answer I thought was not quite clear, but I'm sure that it is number one. If it's number two, I mustn't go to Las Vegas in July.
No, you sure mustn't. You'll be really snowed. All right, the votes are in. Minds are made up. Let's find out for ourselves now how right or wrong we can be as we discover which one of these gentlemen is the real publisher of the Farmer's Almanac. So will the real Rob Sagendorf please stand up? All I can say is it's been nice knowing you, Pat.
Yes, it sure has.
I'm afraid we haven't time, Kitty. I wish we had. There's a lot to talk about. We'll have to talk about afterwards. Number one, would you tell us your real name and what you really do, please?
My name is Beeman Todd.
Just a minute, please. We want to introduce the others to you, if you don't mind. Number one.
My name is Beeman Todd, and I'm president of Todd and Draper Corporation, Management Consultants.
Thank you, sir. Number three, your real name and what you do, please.
I'm Lee Gorman, General Sales Manager, WINS Radio, New York.
Thank you, sir. And again, we have four incorrect votes at $250 each for a total from Helene Curtis of $1,000. Gentlemen, a clean sweep against our panel. I don't recall that ever happening before, and we sure hope it never happens again. And a gift box of fine beauty products from Helene Curtis for you ladies. Thanks again. Hope you had fun. Good night and good luck to you. Well, that's all the time we have for tonight, except to remind you all that through medical research, tuberculosis has been reduced in its...
It's danger. Every one of us is safer because of it. So use Christmas seals, won't you, and help the fight against TB. Well, I guess that's all for tonight, and I mean all for tonight. And what can I say but...
No,
not coming
none
back?
Of us, no.
Then goodbye, panel.
This is
what, God, you're saying goodnight from Aline Curtis and reminding you to tell the truth. Good night, everybody.
To Tell the Truth is a Mark Crooks and Bill Kaufman production in association with CBS Television Network. Johnny Carson may be seen daily on Who Do You Trust? This week's show has been brought to you by Helene Curtis, makers of Endin Dandruff Treatment Shampoo and Tender Touch Dry Skin Bath Oil. Johnny Olson saying goodnight from To Tell the Truth. This program was pre-recorded.